Grant, we pray, Almighty God, the soul of your servant, Sister Mary Faustina, who for love of Christ walked the way of perfect charity, may rejoice in the coming of your glory, and together with her sisters, may delight in the everlasting happiness of your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
be to God.
So they took Jesus and carried him across himself. He went out to a place called the place of the Lord. In Hebrew, God. There he was right with him, with two others, one on either side, with Jesus in the middle. Standing by the cross of Jesus, where his mother and his mother sit, Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her to his mother. After this, the way that everything was now finished, in order that the scriptures might be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I thirst." There was a vessel filled with common wine. So they put a sponge soaked in the wine on a string of it and put it up to his mouth. When Jesus had taken the wine, he said, "It is finished." And bowing his head, he handed over his spirit. Now, since there was preparation day, in order that the bodies might not remain on the cross on the Sabbath, for the Sabbath day of the week was a Sabbath, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and that they would be taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and then of the other who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately blood and water flowed out. An eyewitness was testified, and his testimony is true. He knows that he is speaking the truth, so that you may also come to believe. For this happened, so that the scriptures passage might be fulfilled. Not a bone of will be broken. And again another passage says, they will look upon him whom they have pierced. The gospel.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'd like to be closer to you, to Faustina. She shows the readings. I had another reading in mind. I'll tell you later which one. But this one was chosen by her. So she brings us back to Calvary. And we are all now on Calvary. And there is great pain by everyone. And there is suffering. And there is fear. And some of the apostles are running away on the way to Emmaus, hiding someplace in the city. Peter just denied him. It's a moment really of pain, sorrow, and then comes the last moment. The side receives that glance. It is finished. We can only feel that when we ourselves experience the mystery of the cross. When someone we love, or someone close to us, when we ourselves go through the cross. And at that moment, a vacuum, an emptiness. So what is Faustina telling us? The second reading, hope never fails. Hope. And that is what we learn from Mary. Suffering was there. The cross was very real for her also, because her son was being crucified. El dolor de María era una realidad, pero nunca perdía la esperanza. Immediately after Golgotha is the resurrection. It's the life. So today we come with all those feelings of sorrow and pain. Some of you more than others. Some of you probably didn't even meet her, at least seen her in one of your gallivantings in Plainfield or in the Bronx. But very little. And yet, some of you have sorrow, pain, because you were close to her. And yet, with that pain and that sorrow, comes hope. She will rise because Christ is risen from the dead. It's all about Christ. It's not about Faustina. It's not about Mother Teresa. It's not about St. Paul. It's about Christ. Dead and risen from the dead. And so, we come because we believe in those readings. We believe in Christ. Esa es nuestra fe. Anunciamos su muerte, proclamamos su resurrección. Ven, Señor Jesús. So now I ask you, what did Sister Faustina give you? I don't know. Maybe I'll have to go to Idaho, where she was born, to find out if there is some property that she left. I doubt she had a bank account in Idaho. What did she leave you? What is her legacy? What is the gift that she leaves? After somebody dies, we always ask that question. What is the legacy? Some people think it's treasure. So all the neighbors and friends and everybody come visit, they read the will. No, not a treasure. What is the legacy that she left to the missionaries of charity and to all of us? You know something? After all these years, I don't know, but Alekaserka and I have been working for these 40 years to the missionaries of charity on Albertine Street. I hardly know. I've seen it every Monday, sometimes by the window. Sometimes by the wall, sometimes back at the window, sometimes back at the wall. And that's all I've seen of Faustina in 40 years or so. Same with you, Bernadette. Just checking if you are awake. All I knew was her name, Faustina. It was the other day that I found she had a last name. Somos, I couldn't even pronounce it. And just the other day I met that she was from Idaho. But you see, all those things are superficial. What did I know about Faustina? I don't even know how she picked that name. I asked one of the sisters, why was she called Faustina? Did she choose Faustina, or did Mother Superior come and say, you're called Faustina? We don't know. But the name fit the person perfectly. She was very much like Saint Faustina Kowalski. But that's her legacy. Her love for Christ and her understanding of the mercy of Christ, the divine mercy, la divina misericordia y el amor de Dios. That's our legacy. That's what is left for the missionaries of charity and for all of us. I asked him the sacristan, what do you know about Faustina? Our sister knew as little as I did, or as much as I did. She was compassionate, I was told. She was compassionate. She had a great love for the heart of Jesus. Somebody said they were bringing photos of And I said, good things to the Sacred Heart, but I don't know where they went. I guess they forgot to bring them. Because that would have been the appropriate place to have her phone next to the Sacred Heart. She had great devotion. Un gran devoción al Sagrado Corazón. Y me alegro que las señoras del Sagrado Corazón están aquí con sus uniformes. So happy to see the Sacred Heart ladies here. Porque en el corazón de Jesús está el amor, está la misericordia, está la entrega, está el cariño y la ternura de un Dios que no nos abandona, de un Dios que siempre está con nosotros. The tenderness, the love of a God that is always with us, that walks with us, that accompanies us through Golgotha to the cross, to the resurrection at the empty tomb. Her legacy is precisely what you say every day. She preached without preaching. Not by words, but by her example. The sympathetic smile of what we do. How can I forget the smile of Faustina when I went to the hospital? She was in pain. She was in sorrow. And the sisters, this is the way we act. Our bishop is here. You better wake up. Well, she opened her eyes and she smiled. I said, Faustina, are you in great pain? That's the way she said it, with a smile. That sympathetic smile, what we do. We know of her suffering. We knew. I could see from the altar her difficulty sometimes in standing, in sitting, the neck. We know that she was in pain, but always with a smile. Always expressing a soul that is open to the light of Christ, to hope, to the resurrection. So, sisters, today think about what did Sister Faustina give you in your faith. Now, she wasn't a saint. Neither am I, neither is Father Thomas, Father Severa, Sister Bernadette. We all lose our pensions, don't we? We are sinful people. So was she. Because we all need God's love and mercy. That's why we have a Mass. To reaffirm us, to confirm us in the faith of Christ, who loves us and forgives us. And we come to pray for Sister Faustina, that the love of God may be hers, that he may be merciful with her soul, forgive whatever sins she may have committed, and admit her in the heavenly place he has for each and every one of us. And our prayers is for ourselves too, that we may understand the message of that Sacred Heart. In ti confio, in you I trust, in you I trust, and we trust. understands us, when we feel alone, when we feel that we cannot walk anymore, when we feel that we cannot kneel, that we have to look for a bench, when we feel that everything is falling, when we feel that nobody loves us. Señor, en ti confío. Lord, in you I trust. Sagrado Corazón de Jesús. Sagrado Corazón de Jesús. Sagrado Corazón de Jesús. Let us bring our prayer to the light.
In baptism, first we receive the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness and now be burned over the bodies of them. Lord, in your mercy. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and awaken them. Grant us everlasting love and everlasting home in your Son, Lord, your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Many people die by this war of famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer. So I bless them. These signs and seeing these sins against your love and gather them to you.
Let us now turn to our Blessed Mother and ask her to carry our prayers for her son, so that they can be presented to God the Father. Hail Mary.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, on your servant, Mary Faustina, for whom we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly entreating that reconciled with you through these devoted offices, she may merit to rise again to life. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has gone, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. So with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be
Sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your building church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, and Octavius, our Bishop, the other bishops of the clergy, and the entire people who have came for your love. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family. You have summoned before you, with your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant, Sister Faustina, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth, he will raise up the flesh of those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, forsaking you, our God, as you are. We shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
As we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant you peace, unity, and accordance to your will, live and reign forever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Mm-hmm.